ta'ala. So the servants of the Most Merciful do not witness assemblies of falsehood, nor do they bear false witness. Both, they do not do both. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ يَخُوضُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ وَإِمَّا يُنْسِيَنَّكَ الشَّيْطَانُ فَلَا تَقْعُدْ بَعْدَ الذِّكْرَ مَعَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. He said, if you see those who talk idly, who talk offensively, who has offensive discourse against our science, our revelation, then you know what you should do is to avoid them, is to ignore them. Do not be with them until they change the topic of their discourse and talk about something else. And if shaitan makes you forgetful, makes you forget, and you stay with them, then as soon as you remember, leave them and don't be with the zalimeen. Don't be with the wrongdoers. Don't sit with them if they do that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said to Rasulullah, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ وَكَانَ أَمْرُهُ فُرُطًا. He said, persevere in patience with those who call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning and in the evening, and do not overlook them. Do not turn your eyes away from them, and wanting the amusement, wanting the pomp of this dunya, and then do not obey him whose heart was made by Allah heedless. وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا. And he followed his caprice. وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ وَكَانَ أَمْرُهُ فُرُطًا. And everything of his affairs was negligence. Do not obey him. Do not obey such person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, considers az-zur, shahadat az-zur, bearing false witness, as a great sin. As a great sin. For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ عَدَلَتْ شَهَادَةُ الزُّورِ شِرْكًا بِاللَّهِ. He said that three times. عَدَلَتْ شَهَادَةُ الزُّورِ شِرْكًا بِاللَّهِ. عَدَلَتْ شَهَادَةُ الزُّورِ شِرْكًا بِاللَّهِ. Three times. ثُمَّ قَرَأْ فَاجْتَنِبُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ حُنَفَاءَ لِلَّهِ غَيْرَ مُشْرِكِينَ بِهِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that bearing false witness is equivalent to associating with Allah partners. He said that three times. Bearing false witness is equivalent to associating partners with Allah three times. And then he read the ayah, فَجَتَنِبُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ. Avoid the filthiness or the uncleanliness of idols. فَاجْتَنِبُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ وَاجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ. And avoid uttering falsehood or witnessing falsehood. يعني سبحان الله. And this is in Surah Al-Hajj. عن عبد الرحمن بن أبي بكرة عن أبيه رضي الله عنهما. عبد الرحمن بن أبي بكرة, on the authority of his father, may Allah be pleased with them both, he said, كنا عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال ألا أنبئكم بأكبر الكبائر ثلاثا. He said, should I tell you with the greatest of sins? He said, الإشراك بالله, to associate partners with Allah, وعقوق الوالدين, and disobedience to parents, وعقوق الوالدين وشهادة الزور, and bearing witness to falsehood. وكان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم متكئا فجلس. And he was lying down, and then he sat down, and he said, وشهادة الزور وشهادة الزور وشهادة الزور. And he kept repeating that until the Sahaba said, we wish that he remained silent, because he was so annoyed by that, Rasulullah sallam. And they had, you know, they were, يعني, subhanAllah, saddened because Rasulullah sallam was, they did not want Rasulullah to be annoyed and to be like, you know, saddened. And because Rasulullah sallam kept saying, وَشَهَادَةُ الزُّورِ وَشَهَادَةُ الزُّورِ, he was warning, you know, them of that. Of witnessing falsehood. And also Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِيَّاكُمْ وَالْكَذِبُ, beware of lying, فَإِنَّ الْكَذِبَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْفُجُورِ, for lying leads to sin, leads to sin. وَإِنَّ الْفُجُورَ يَهْدِي إِلَى النَّارِ, and sin leads to the fire of hell. وَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَكْذِبُ وَيَتَحَرَّ الْكَذِبَ حَتَّى يُكْتَبَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَذَّابًا, and a man or a woman will practice lying and will seek to say lies until he is written with Allah as a liar. Subhanallah. وَعَلَيْكُمْ بِالصُّدْقِ, and take on truthfulness, for truthfulness, فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ, for truthfulness leads to graciousness, leads to righteousness, and graciousness leads to الجنة, وإن البر يهدي إلى الجنة, وإن الرجل لا يصدق ويتحرى الصدق حتى يكتب عند الله صديقا. And a man still says the truth and seeks to say the truth all the time until he is written with Allah as a truthful, as a truthful person. سبحان الله. وقال, for a man of truth, وقال, ويل الذي يحدث فيكذب ليضحك به القوم ويل له ثم ويل له. He says, woe to him that utters, that talks and utters lies to make people laugh. Woe to him, woe to him. ويل له, ويل له. تحذير, warning from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى أن عباد الرحمن إذا مروا باللغو مروا مرور الكرام, متنزهين عن مشاركتهم في سفههم وعبثهم. And he said, when servants of the Most Merciful pass by assemblies of gossip and of backbiting and of alcohol and of gambling and so forth, they go pass by a passing of those who have honor and dignity. They avoid that. They do not participate in those assemblies. They do not take part in them. They avoid them. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them because when they listen to the Quran, they become all ears. They become all ears, meaning they listen attentively to the Quran, and they listen to it by a great awareness and by a great, يعني, subhanAllah, care. They listen to the Quran and they love to listen to it, and they concentrate completely on the Quran. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Qaf, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَى السَّمْعَى وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ. So when we, يعني, listen to the Quran, we should be all ears to it, and we should contemplate about what we are reading, and we should be aware, 100% concentrating on the Quran. And this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them because they were doing so. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. When the Quran is being read, then listen to it and be all ears, be attentive to it, so that you may be, so that Allah may be merciful to you. وذلك على عكس الكافرين والمشركين الذين يصمون آذانهم. This is opposite to the state of the unbelievers and those who associate partners with Allah. Because when they hear the Quran, they do not listen to it and they do not concentrate on it. Some of them will close their ears. They will close their ears so that they want to prevent themselves from hearing the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ. And the disbelievers said, do not listen to this Quran and make noises when you listen to it, so that it is interrupted, to interrupt it and to, you know, to distract others from listening to it. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ, so that you may be victorious, so that you may overcome, you know, the believers. وَقَالَ رَبُّنَا سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا فِي أَكِنَّةٍ مِّمَّا تَدْعُونَ إِلَيْهِ وَفِي آذَانِنَا وَقْرٌ وَمِن بَيْنِنَا وَبَيْنِكَ حِجَابٌ فَاعْمَلْ إِنَّنَا عَامِلُونَ. Those disbelievers said that our hearts are wrapped up by coverings against what you are calling us to embrace, you know. وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا فِي أَكِنَّةٍ مِّمَّا تَدْعُونَ إِلَيْهِ وَفِي آذَانِنَا وَقْرٌ, and in our ears there is deafness. This is what they say. And in our ears there is deafness. وَمِن بَيْنِنَا وَبَيْنَكَ حِجَابٌ, and between you and us there is a curtain, there is a veil. بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكَ حِجَابٌ فَعْمَلْ إِنَّنَا عَامِلُونَ. So, you know, act, we are going to act as well. Or do your deeds, and then we shall do ours. This is what the disbelievers said. So they have, you know, attended deaf ears, and they have covered their hearts, so that the Quran, they do not receive the message of the Quran, so that the Quran will have no impact on them, will not affect their hearts, and will not come through their ears, so that they can, you know, ponder about it or contemplate it. So it will not be of benefit to them. And this is what they chose for themselves, and this is what they are going to get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, of the attributes of the servants of the merciful, is that they prayed to Allah to give them righteous wives and righteous progeny. And righteous progeny. وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. And they pray to Allah to give them righteous wives and righteous children, and make them imams for the righteous people. Subhanallah. So this is what they always ask Allah to give them. You know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الدُّنْيَا مَتَاعٌ وَخَيْرُ مَتَاعَ الدُّنْيَا الْمَرْأَةُ الصَّالِحَةُ. This world is but a provision, and the best of provision is the righteous wife. And the best of provision in this life is the righteous wife, is a righteous wife. الدُّنْيَا مَتَاعٌ وَخَيْرُ مَتَاعَ الدُّنْيَا الْمَرْأَةُ الصَّالِحَةُ وَمِنْ بَيْنِ الْأَشْيَاءِ الَّتِي يَدْعُو بِهَا عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى بِأَنْ يَهَبَهُمْ أَزْوَاجًا صَالِحِينَ زَوْجَاتًا صَالِحِينَ. رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا and from our progeny قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ, a delight of our eyes. You know, those when we look at, we become happy and content and joyful. قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا and made us leaders to those who are righteous. Made us leaders. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about being imam, about being an example, about being a role model, about being a leader in Surah As-Sajdah, when he said, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. So he mentioned two things that if one adheres to, he will be given imamah, he will be a leader in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these two things are as-sabr and al-yaqeen. لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. When they persevered in patience, in fortitude, when they persevered in that, and they attained certitude, they were certain, al-yaqeen, they have certainty, iman, they reached the level of iman to something called al-yaqeen, as if they are seeing that. وهو مقام الإحسان. ما الإحسان؟ قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. Is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you see Allah. And if you cannot see Allah, then rest assured that Allah sees you. So they have reached a level of iman, a very high level of iman. وهو درجة اليقين. وجعلنا منهم أئمة يهدون بأمرنا لما صبروا وكانوا بآياتنا يوقنون. ثم ختم الله سبحانه وتعالى هذه الآيات المباركات بقوله أولئك يجزون الغرفة بما صبروا ويلقون فيها تحية وسلاما. And those who say and those who have all of these attributes that we have talked about, you know, they have tawadu, they have humbleness, and they have hilm, they have forbearance, and they do not spend extravagantly, nor they are greedy, nor they are miserly, nor they are stingy. All of these do not associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not commit fornication, do not murder a human soul unjustly, and all of the other attributes that we have talked about. He said, "Ulaika," those who have these attributes, ulaika, and subhanallah, this is ism ishara, يعود على عباد الرحمن وصدرت به الآية للتنبيه على أن عباد الرحمن أحرياء بما سيذكر بعده بسبب ما اتصفوا به قبله وهي الصفات التي ذكرناها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put this indicator أولئكَ to point to the servants of the most merciful, those who possessed those beautiful attributes. He says to indicate that they are deserving of what comes after it. أُولَٰئِكَ يُجْزَوْنَ الْغُرْفَةَ بِمَا صَبَرُوا. Those will be rewarded lofty places because of their perseverance in patience. Patience in performing ta'at, in performing acts of obedience. Patience in avoiding acts of disobedience. الصبر على الطاعات وصبرهم عن المعاصي وصبرهم عن على مصائب الدنيا. And their patience when they are afflicted with this world's afflictions. And صبرهم على أذى الناس. And their patience against the harm that comes from people. Subhanallah. When يَا بُنَيَّ أَقِمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَأَمُرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَانْهَى عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ. And Luqman, when he was advising his son, he says, "Oh my son, establish prayer, أَقِمُ الصَّلَاةَ يَا بُنَيَّ أَقِمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَأَمُرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ and command that which is good, وَانْهَى عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ and command against that which is bad, وَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ and persevere in patience against whatever afflicts you. Because when someone is calling people to reform and calling people to khayr, calling people to goodness, he will encounter those people who will harm him. Because some people do not like khayr, they do not like good, they do not like reform, they like corruption. So those corrupt people will harm him, will try to harm him. Allah protects. So that's why النصيحة of Luqman. أولئك يجزون الغرفة بما صبروا. Those will get lofty places in heavens for that, for their perseverance and patience, for their fortitude. ويلقون فيها تحية وسلاما. And they will receive therein, in Jannah, in those lofty places, they will receive greetings and the greeting of peace. They will be honored. You know, we see in dunya when kings and presidents and emperors and whatever, when they come to visit a country, they will have, you know, many